getting a mammogram is never any fun. I don't think anybody likes having it done, but it isn't painful, and I think that's the most common fear. I hear people think that it's really, really, really hurts. It doesn't hurt. It's just a couple of minutes of squishing and you're out. I think there was a lot of fear about what they would find. That's always a concern. But not knowing wasn't going to solve anything, and knowing sooner clearly saved my life, so it was important that we knew sooner. I was 45 years old. I was a busy mom. My son was in college. I was working as an executive, traveling all the time, and my health care got put off a lot. I would wait to go to the doctor. I was very lucky that I got my mammogram on time in 2005, exactly the month I was supposed to have it. And as luck would have it, I didn't have a tumor that you could feel. It was found on routine mammogram and was so small you couldn't see it with the naked eye. And it had already spread into my lymph nodes by that time. So having the mammogram, I am certain, and so is my physician, that having my mammogram on time, and mammogram has improved tremendously over these many years as well. That was pre-digital and pre, 3D imaging and all that sort of thing. So I had really saved my life having my mammogram on time. When you're diagnosed, I think the first thing that you want to do is go somewhere right now, this minute. Let's get treatment started right today. What do we have to do? And the healthcare providers don't work like that, because there's a lot to figure out in those weeks, but certainly figuring out the treatment plan really was worth the wait. My cancer in my lymph nodes was a little bit tentative because only the sentinel node was positive. So they wanted to make sure that chemotherapy really was an option, and even the physicians couldn't agree. So I had to really advocate for myself. That's one of the reasons I got involved with Komen, was I knew as a nurse it was still difficult to navigate, to really get in there and figure out what do I want to know, what are the right questions to ask, how do we figure out what the right treatment for me is going to be. Joan was my nurse navigator, and she showed up at every appointment, and we would talk after we left the appointment, and she would say, okay, are you okay with that? Is this what you want to do? Do you want to see somebody else? Can I make a recommendation for you? Can I help you? And, you think, she's a nurse, I'm a nurse, I don't know if I need her. Well, I did need her. I needed her a lot. Because just as a sounding board. And then I also found other survivors that were farther down the road than I, and they would answer questions and I could bounce things off them. And they really helped me figure out what the right path for me was going to be. I'm here because I got my mammogram on time for a change. And so I remind all my friends, I certainly put it out there always on my different anniversaries, the anniversary of my diagnosis, the anniversary of my last treatment, that if you haven't gone, you need to go. And so I'm really sort of the cheerleader of that, and I know they're all sick of it, but hopefully it keeps them getting their mammograms on time. One of my dearest friends had passed away from breast cancer a number of years prior to me being diagnosed, and her daughter and I are still good friends. And she said to me, you have to do everything so that when you look back, no matter what you choose to do, you're comfortable that you made the best decision you could at the time with the information available, and that you don't have any regrets about the path that you chose. So I think that's the key, is making sure that you've gathered all the information that's out there, and then go forward with the best choice.